Greetings, fellow Oathlings. Welcome back to some more Elder Scrolls Arena. The last time we basically left off, we had already completed Margus's quest. We are currently in Labyrinth, and now we need to, I think, go into Kanen's realm, if that's his name, if I'm not mistaken. And we need to find his key as well, so that we can unlock the final door. Let's just make sure that I had saved the game, because I remember saving it, but I'm not sure. Yeah, I had explored the other side, so time to go through door number two. Alright, let's do this. Nothing here? I mean... Okay, who's... Really? Already? Paralyzed already? I mean, I just started playing, come on, man. Well, that takes care of that. And there are still more spiders nearby. I wonder where we go from here. Huh. Is it perhaps this way? Maybe. Might be. Oh no, we just came back. Like back into the main area. Yeah, I think, so the door is here. We need to take this road here, then go somewhere over here. Take this path, and the door's right there. Alright then. So we take this path, and then we continue onwards this way. More spiders. Wolves. Yep, wolves it is. Huh. I guess we need to go back down, I suppose? I mean, that is the only way I think it is. I mean, oh wait, I think I took like a huge lap. Instead of taking this out, I could have taken this out instead and just reached the door. So, yeah. The Shalidor. Right here. What was this again? To the domain of Kanen. Alright, fine. Let's just save quickly in temp. Just so that, you know, I don't have to find my way here again. You stand before the halls of Kanen. And yeah, let's see. Let's see where this goes. This is a different place. And this place already looks different. Quite different. I mean, it's nothing like the other place, so... Yeah. I can't even reach them there. Can I... Yeah, let's just equip this quickly. I just hope that my, you know, elven longsword doesn't break like my Saber of Agility did, so... Anyway, so Mark of Visits Fire. I still do have it. I mean... I think I can use it. The mark is broken. I think I'll need to get it repaired then. I suppose I, like... use it too much, I suppose. So, mark of shocking, it is then. And when all else fails, we can always rely on our... unknown mark. I can't use this? I guess I'll need to be in been like a closer range to use it, I suppose. Huh. So the way back is through here. And how did I get over here then? Oh wait, no, that's Morgus's side. So I guess I'll just mark this as back as well. They're right next to each other, but the pathways and all seem so different. The entire layout, that is. Well, I guess I can appreciate the effort the developers put in the game like this, so... I'll just jump. Okay. And that was a fail. What I don't like sometimes about these enemies is that they will just stand in your way and block it. I mean, they won't let you move. And that's something which I don't always appreciate. about this game. I mean, I can't exactly blame the game either. It's like pretty old, but yeah. So, I mean, there isn't anything much here. So where are we left to go? We can explore this way. We can explore this way. I guess I'll just try exploring this way first then. I mean, if I just take a moment to show you guys, I started this quest out with around 3k gold, like 3000 gold, and right now I already have like around 13,000, so exploring these dungeons is quite worth it. I mean, it's definitely worth it. Just look at this. Yeah. And I need to swing like crazy now, because this guy's blocking my path, so yeah, thanks for that. Thanks for nothing, spider. I mean, I could always use the pauldron of levitation against these guys, but yeah, what the hell. Am I not hitting you? Yeah, finally. I mean, I sort of want to avoid doing that because that really takes the edge of my blades quite quickly, and it makes them break sooner as well, but yeah, as you can see, it's slightly used. Just slightly used, not much. So yeah, I mean, I can use it as well. I mean, I might as well use it like that. So this way has nothing. Okay. Strange. But I guess it is what it is then, huh? Back over to this side then, I suppose. Another thing which I don't really understand about this game is if I ever have to like jump into a forward jump, I really need to like let go of the mouse and press the shift and J key together. I guess we'll take this path. And that really, you know, is a little off-putting to me, but then again, I mean, I suppose we could try using the tunnel to go this way. I mean, I can hear a cool, but I just don't know where it is, so, and this seems to be a dead end, but this seems to be a way up, so I guess I'll try this place out. No? No. No way out here. Dude, I was just going up. Come on. Come on, you can do it. You can do it. Yeah, that's it. See? Much easy. Much better. These tunnels aren't exactly the most reliable thing. They don't always let you get up anywhere you want to, so... I guess I'll try this way again, the way we went last time. Because, I mean, I can't exactly think of what else I can do here. Oh, come on. So, sometimes what happens is when you have your weapon equipped, you just can't jump. And that's another thing which, you know, doesn't really make sense to me, but alright, I mean, if that's what the game is, that's what the game is, I guess. And this place looks familiar. I hear spiders. There you are. And two zombies. Well, thank you for nothing, I guess. I mean, they just sprung up out of nowhere, and that's something new in this game. I mean, I haven't seen this before. I wonder if it's because I'm moving too fast for the game to, you know, actually render before I arrive. But I don't know. That really hasn't ever happened to me. We can try going down here. because there doesn't really seem to be anything much here apart from this tunnel, which, if you know me, I should like to explore later. Oh yeah, I forgot to mark this as back. And I shall save once again in case I run into some hellhounds, which would be pretty bad, so yeah. And I guess this is the way I came through, so... We can try going here. Let's try. I really don't want to crawl into a tunnel, to be honest. Seriously? You overshot the jump? And another thing that I do have to look out for is my fatigue as well, because if I get too fatigued, that just means that I can't fight. It's more like I'll just be paralyzed. And yeah, that sucks. Because you can't do anything, and you're just gonna have to wait until the next demon comes and essentially kills you off, so yeah, it's basically death. It's got like two health bars in this game. I hear more spiders. Okay. I wonder how much I'll need to explore in this map, but let's see. I guess we can try going down here, I suppose, or should we try going down here? I don't know, I really don't know. At any rate, let's just... drop down, I suppose? And then we can decide where to go, and where not to go. Should we go straight? I mean, we can, so... I like the fact that, you know, they can't exactly get you when you're inside those tunnels and burrows, but yeah. Getting out of them is another thing entirely. Okay, something took a swipe at me. What was it? Ah, a spider behind me. Amazing. And a mark. So, I'll just... I need to go ahead and equip my mark of shocking. Because why not? I mean, I have that, so might as well use it. I wonder if I can get him from here. Oh yeah, I can. How convenient. I'll just use a potion of field rule and... I mean, this was actually coincidental. The potion of heal true does not free your actions, it just did in this case, but yeah. It doesn't always happen. Let's try going down here, I guess. Do I want to get out here? I wonder. Or do you want to continue down the same path that I am on? I'll just continue down it. Let's see where this takes us. The sad part about this is that you really need to be looking where you want to go, otherwise you can't go there. And I already hear some... hellhounds there. So I'll just go ahead and use the potion of resist fire and save the game here. Because I don't want to come back all this way in case I die. Are you dead yet? Yes, you are. And that is good. And I mean the potion of resist elements, like the potions of which give you resistance towards elements, they play a huge part in damage reduction. I had initially underestimated this fact, but they really do. I mean, they're really helpful, so it's always worthwhile to, like, use them. And I guess we can keep going down here. We'll just... Well, let's just see. I mean, I have no particular, you know, plan as to how I'm gonna do this. I'm just seeing where we can go as we go. Left or right, left or right. Let's toss a coin. Right. Yeah. I don't know what that was, but that was something. Let me just save again. Just in case. So that I don't have to face those... Wait, is this... Oh yeah! Well, would you look at that? I guess I'll, you know, like, explore more of this dungeon after I'm done with this. You know, like, a little bit here, a little bit there. But then again, I mean, the structure of this dungeon is a little weird, I feel like. So... I don't know, let's see how it feels to, you know, like, go around in this place and keep searching. So, yeah. I am the brother Kanen, who holds the secrets of life. Not a more cunning riddler, twixt ocean and thief. Huh. Let me just search up the meaning of those words. I don't really have a good vocabulary, but, yeah. This game actually uses quite a lot of old words, and I suppose I can appreciate that. So, twixt. Hmm. Betwixt? Ah, between. See, it's an archaic word. And thief. Hmm. Piece of land held under the feudal system. Answer me this question, O foolish mortal from above, or join my eternal task, born of duty and love. Hmm. Two bodies have I, though both joined in one. The more still I stand, the quicker I run. Okay. What is thy answer? So this would be the cue where you should pause the video, because I'm just gonna cut to when I have already solved the puzzle now. So yeah, now, time to think. Okay, so I couldn't exactly understand what this puzzle actually, like, meant, and at first I thought it was engine, because, you know, like, there's like two bodies and one, actually multiple bodies, but I don't know if it's like a two-valve engine and stuff. But then again, I realized that, you know, engine is probably not the right answer. And then I realized that it is probably a candle, because, you know, the flame and the candle is or a torch is basically like two bodies in one, and if you actually just let it stand there, it I guess runs out quickly. So, or a match, but apparently that was the wrong answer, and I basically got slaughtered by Kanen here. What happens when you answer wrongly is that this guy, he comes out of his prison and he will butcher you. So you do not want to answer wrong, and I couldn't solve this, so I went online and I had to check. Hey, if I can't do it, I can't do it, right? No shame in seeking help. So yeah, apparently the answer is hourglass. I am free to fly the wind after an eternity of sickness and sin. As a reward for setting me free, the cell next to this holds your sapphire key. A diamond key and a sapphire key. Well, isn't that good? And it even looks different. So I'll just save you. And, yeah, where to now? What I like about this part is that there were multiple ways to approach this part, actually, like this section of Labyrinthian, like Kanen's side, there were actually multiple paths to approach this. For example, we have one path here, we've got more paths here and here, so yeah, I guess it was a better designed version of this one, because as we can see here, I mean, this practically like only one path to and from here. So yeah, I mean, the only way you can come in here is through this path here, so I guess I would think that this map is more emergent, like Kanen's side, but yeah, I digress. It's still built quite weirdly with all these like niches and corridors, so I don't really know what to make of it. Do I hear what I think I hear? Hellhounds? And where are these hellhounds? Okay, so this was here. I guess we drop down and go this way? I mean, we do have a long ways to go, so... drop down here, take this road. And where to now? I guess we can take a right and... but I don't think it will join it, will it? I guess there's no harm in trying. Or else we can just, you know, like explore this part. Huh. Take a right, take a left. Come out here. Let's see. Okay, am I not in the right spot? I am, but why isn't it letting me... Ah. See, this is what I mean about this place. I mean, they don't always let you get up all the time, so... So there's that. I guess I can get up here and get attacked by this ghoul, like, immediately. And that ghoul is stuck there. I'll just use this chance to take a potion of heal true and go ahead and fight this one. And do you have anything for me? Nothing usable? Same here. Alright. So where do I wanna go now? I guess I'll... Yeah, I mean, we have explored this place except for this part. And I don't really think there is much there except for just some treasure, so... I suppose we can bypass it. And what we need to do is we need to go straight, then take the next left. Go straight. Straight, left, right. Right, jump over, and we have a destination. Oh, come on. Not that. I keep hitting the S key when I'm supposed to be hitting the, like, A key, so... Yeah, that's what's causing this, basically. That's what is causing this. We overshot. Get back down, take the right, which you do get, the free right. Free rights! Yay! Oh, come on! Not again. I mean, I have got like a lot of carriage space, like storage carrying capacity, but I can't exactly use that because... well... I think I'm going the wrong way. Yes, I am. No, I am going the right way. Alright. So, basically I can't use any of that storage capacity. Like, I've got 164 kilos worth of storage capacity, which I cannot use because... well, my inventory gets full before I even get to using that. So, yeah. And it seems like we have completed both sides of the puzzle, so... I mean, that was quite quick, like, relatively quite quick. So... let's see if there are... Yep. On cue. On cue. I won't be opening the door yet, I'll take care of all the spiders here. And then I shall heal first. I mean, you really need a lot of potions. I wasn't mistaken when I had taken, like, 100. Potions of healing, and heal true on that, because, like, potions of healing don't heal you all the way. And I shall save you now, because I don't want to redo that part again. So, yeah. You open the door with a sapphire key. What now? Do I get attacked by something? Some more? Here lies the final portal, the doorway to life. What force and strength cannot get through, I, with a gentle touch, can do. and many in these twisted halls would stand, were I not as a friend at hand. So I had actually tried a lot of things, like, you know, I went back to down the main corridor of this, what do you call this, the pathway, which I took to, you know, get here. So I went back there and I searched, I read all the text again and searched for answers, and I couldn't exactly find any. I tried a few guesses, unsuccessful yet again, and these puzzles are really something. And apparently the answer for this would be key, and like, you know, the key to a lock. And I mean, if you can't get through a door with force and strength, like, a key can do it for you. So yeah, I could have, you know, like, solve these puzzles on my own, but oh well. Thou art truly worthy of Shalidor's prize. The second piece of the Staff of Chaos awaits. It's the shaft. The second piece of the Staff of Chaos burns brightly with cold fire as it touches the first piece. They melt together perfectly. Awesome! Time to save. Yeah, right here. I wonder why there isn't, like, any other loot here, which is really surprising to me. Anyway, time to GTFO! I mean, since we had been using keys to unlock doors until now, I thought it would have been a little more... I guess the devs thought it would have been a little more obvious, but yeah, me being me, it wasn't. So, should we go ahead and check out Dawnstar? I wonder. Or Vitron. I mean, because we already have, like, the second piece, so... We're just gonna have to wait for, you know, Rhea Silmane's Dream Bridge, so I guess it doesn't really matter where we go. Vitron it is. You will have to wait until tomorrow if you're planning on making any equipment purchases, for all stores are closed in observance of Sun's Rest. Of course, the temples, taverns, and major guilds in the city-state are still open their regular hours, but most citizens choose to devote this day to relaxation, not commerce or prayer. This is not a convenient arrangement for all, but the merchant's guild heavily fines any shop that stays open, so everyone complies. Wow. You've arrived in the city-state of Vitron in Skyrim province. The date is Sundas. Okay. Took 4 days. For travelers, we offer a place of rest, and rest is what I have come here to seek. Alright, so I'll just, I mean, I do have a few things marked here. I mean, I guess I should have an inn marked here as well? No? Well, I guess not. I guess we'll just have to search for another one again. Yeah, I mean, I think I rested here the last time I came here, but God knows. Oh well. I'll just save once again, because why not? And yeah, I don't think I need anything else. My sword's out, and I guess that's all that we really need at this point. And this would be a weaponry store, so nothing here, in case I haven't identified it yet. There should be an inn somewhere nearby, to be honest. There should. Doesn't mean there, like, would be. But yeah, you get the point. This is a dungeon. Another weapon store. Ah, this is an inn, I guess. I'm not really sure. Okay, I guess this is the Mage's Guild then. It is huge, yep. This is the Mage's Guild. And this is an inn, yes. Ooh, hello, courtesan. Aren't you lovely? Beautiful. The Queen's Ogre. I'm surprised there wasn't an encounter this time around, but... Yeah, how do the Kurasans actually stand outside in the night, you know, without ever being subject to such encounters? But at least, I mean, we have a resource which we can check out as soon as we get to the real mainstream bridge, so, yeah. You're greeted by the warm laughter and merry talk as you enter the Queen's Ogre. Torches around the tavern shed light on this cool summer night. Yeah, that's it. I'll just cheat this, and I shall get a remarkably enigmatic aristocrat called Inkte nervously draws you aside as you approach the bar. I need your help. If this invitation isn't at Elite Tool Store where Mondas 20% sunside, my life isn't going to be worth a pauper. Someone will be there to take the invitation if you're there on time, and I'm sure they'll give it 204 gold for it. Okay. Yay! My mind is much easier. Good luck to you, good lord. Let's get a beer. Just one, please. Alright, fine. I mean, I've got enough gold, so... And let's just climb over and... camp here. Everyone's looking at me. Bye. Except for this guy, I mean, he's busy drinking his own drink. What is this guy doing? Anyway, I'll just camp until fully healed. Huh. I would congratulate you on retrieving the second piece of the Staff of Chaos, Grimfangs, but dire portents have I seen. The third piece of the staff lies somewhere in the Elden Grove, an ancient home of the elves. The Elden Grove is said to be the birthplace of the sacred first tree, that which gave life to all the forests on the continent of Tamriel. Next please. Tamriel, yeah. Its location has been a closely guarded secret, so guarded in fact that many believe that even the elves have forgotten its true location. Considering that there are only three provinces that hold any of the elven people, your search should not be too difficult. Find the Elden Grove and recover the third piece of the staff. I wish you well on your quest. Thank you very much, Rhea. Alright, so... And this is why I... Oh yeah, I forgot. Sorry. So this is why I... said that it's lucky that we have a courtesan right outside this inn. Because otherwise it gets really difficult, like searching for things. And oh yeah, we don't need it right now. Like courtesans. How long did I sleep for? What's the time right now? 2:29 at night. Okay. So if I so courtesans, clowns, and like rogues, they have got like pretty detailed information for you. So if I just go ahead and yeah, let's just ask. Yeah, comforting words. Yeah, so if I ask her where Elden Grove is... Ah, isn't that just a legend? Damn. And here I thought that she might have an answer for me. Oh well. I guess I'll just... how long? 4 hours, I guess? Yeah, just 4 hours. I'm in a different room this time? Huh, curious. Ah yes, so right here, see. You wouldn't be the first searching for that. Why don't you try somewhere in the cities of Valandwood? I heard something happened there. So, if you ask, these courtesans and these rogues and these jesters, you have a much better chance of actually receiving a proper answer to your question. So yeah, that's that. And if I'm not wrong, I think we should be getting assaulted by one of Yegathan's followers anytime now. Why are all you guys surrounding me? Like, haven't you like seen the Nod before in Skyrim? Come on, seriously. So, Alright guys, so I've actually been waiting for quite a long time now, and I ran a couple of errands and basically bought some stuff. I still have like 25,000, more than 25,000 gold left, and I got an ebony broadsword and a saber of agility. Exchanged my elven longsword for an elven longsword of strength, which should be better. And yeah, hopefully my swords won't break that easily. I also got a mark of visits file, a mark of firestorm, and I replenished all my potions of heal true, which I have 101 of now. And I identified all these unidentified things in my inventory, and this actually like sort of revealed two things. My braces were actually braces of wizard lock, and my ring was actually ring of healing, so that's quite useful to know. And unfortunately Yggdrasil hasn't, you know, exploited the dream bridge to send his minion over and attack me, and I guess he'll attack me when he'll attack me. So until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow Oathlings.